The topic is trigger. Now, first of all, what is trigger? Triggers are the stored programs which are automatically executed or fired before or after the occurrence of some event. Now, let's break the statement into portions. First is, triggers are stored programs. They are some sort of programs that are stored on the server which are automatically executed or fired. Now, the situation is, you don't have to fire the trigger, you don't have to execute it. Once you will create the trigger, they will be fired automatically. They will be fired on their own. Fine. So next thing is, before and after, before or after the occurrence of some events. Now there are two things. One is before and after, another is event. First of all, what are the events? Events are like you are performing any sort of query, like you're performing insert, delete DML queries, you're performing DDL queries, or you're performing some sort of database operation. All these are some sort of event. You're performing something on your database, you're performing something on your table, and that is some sort of event. Now the thing is, you will decide whether you want the trigger to be fired before the occurrence of this event, or whether you want this trigger to be fired after the occurrence of this event. Fine. So you will decide before and after position. Second thing, you will decide the event, whether you are talking about update, delete, insert, create, alter, what event you are talking about. So two things will be defined by you. So this is when it will be done, when the trigger will be fired. Now the second, another thing is, I'm going to take an example of a table. I'm just going to take a scenario. Scenario is, I'm going to create a table first, employee table. In that, I'm going to have some few columns, and there will be one column salary. Fine. Another thing is, I want to maintain a record that whenever somebody is trying to change or trying to update the salary of my table, that should be saved in another table. A record of that should be saved in another table. Another thing is, how the record will be saved, there will be another table with three things, ID, name, and some message that there is some updation. So let's create the table first. And who will perform this task for me? I'll plan trigger for that. Okay, let's start the thing. Let's create the table first. So our table has been created. Fine, so I just created a table simple using create table, table name, and then simple create query. Fine, after that I inserted 4 rows into this, and as you can see in the table I have ID, name, and salary. 3 rows. Now the second thing is, I'm going to create one more table. Execute. I got message, table created. Fine. And in this table I have 3 columns, ID, new salary, and message. Let me show you the table. Just try table name, because it's already been done. So I'm getting the message, name is already used by the existing object. So I'll remove this command. Execute. So in this table I have ID, new salary, and message. 3 columns. And if I apply the select command, select star from table name, and there's nothing there, no row selected, because we haven't inserted any data there. Now I already have one table. That table was select . This was my table 1, 4 rows there. This was my table 2, nothing there. So now let's write the code for trigger. You will write the code as simple. The first line is create trigger, and after that you are writing trigger name. Simple, like you do create table, table name. Same way you will write create trigger, trigger name. First line clear. Second line is, here you will define 4 things. See, whenever you are planning the trigger, you have to decide when the trigger will be fired and what it will do. Our first parameter is when the trigger will be fired. So I'm saying that it will be fired after. I can also write before, but I want the trigger to be fired after the update. So the first thing is I'll decide after or before. Second thing is I'll decide the event. Update, delete, insert, like any event. So I have decided it will be executed after update of, that's your keyword, which column. I'm talking about the salary column. If there is any updation of the salary column, after that this trigger will be fired. But I haven't mentioned I'm talking about which table. There might be salary column might be present in so many columns, so many tables. So on table name. So there are four things. After and before, decided I want to the trigger to be fired after. Event, updation, deletion, insertion, selection, alteration, what event? I have decided it will be update. What column I'm talking about? Salary. What table I'm talking about? This table. Clear? Four parameters. Now the next line is for each row. I want this trigger to be fired that whenever there is updation of any row. I'm talking about all the rows. I don't want to exclude any row. I want this trigger to be fired if there is updation of any row which is present in the table. So that's why I have written the line for each row. Clear? Now the thing is we are done with the thing that when it will be fired, but we haven't said anything what it will do, what our trigger will do, what's the use of our trigger. So my case was, my scenario was, what my trigger will do, it will add a record in another table. Record will be like the ID of the employee and his updated salary, and a message will be recorded in another table. Fine. So since I'm saying that a record will be added into another table, and of course that will be insert query, because I want to add a new row to the table, and that is simple, our insert query. Clear? So I have written insert into table name, then the column names, simple, values, the simple what we do for insert query, insert into table name, then our column names followed by values keyword. Now this thing, something new is here. You have two words, one is old and one is new. Old means, see, when you're performing updation, you have two stages. One is your old value and one is your new value. Old value is the value before the updation, and new value is value after the updation. And since I'm going to update, since I have applied the trigger on the salary only, updation of salary, so the ID will remain old. So you will write, and one more thing, you will write column. Every value will be preceded by a colon. Colon old ID. Colon old dot ID, comma, colon new dot salary, because I want the updated salary. Fine. Comma, any message, you can display any message. Let's say I want to updation performed. Fine. You can display any message here. Now if we click on execute, trigger has been created. And one more thing, if I execute it again, it says trigger already exists. That means because names has to be unique, so I cannot create this trigger again. Another error that you can do is, let's say there is some issue with my table. I'm going to create some error with my trigger. I'm going to change the name of the column from ID to something else. And let's create another trigger. 1, 2, 3. Execute. I got the message, trigger created with compilation errors. My actual trigger was trigger this much, trigger eg, which was done successfully. Then intentionally I created this trigger, intentionally or maybe by mistake, somehow I just created this trigger and that's present into my system. Now the thing is, now it's the time to check whether our trigger is working fine or not. So the command is, I want to perform the updation of the salary. Update emp kkk set salary equals to, let's say I want to set the salary to this, where ID equals to 2. Fine. And after that I want to check the table. Select start from table name. It says that trigger EG 123 invalid and failed re-delegation because there were some compilation errors with my second trigger by mistake which I executed. So that trigger is creating some sort of problems with my my table, and it's not letting my table to be updated. Fine. So I want to drop this trigger because that there was some compilation error. I want to drop it. So I'll write drop trigger. Whatever the trigger is creating problems, I want to delete it. Control C, Control V, and execute. That the trigger with the error was deleted. I just had one trigger that was triggered EG that was done successfully. Fine. So that trigger has performed its action. I don't have to do anything. I haven't touched the trigger. If I say now the role for the ID 2, the salary has been updated. Fine. Let's say I want to update the salary of role number 3 as well. Sorry, ID 3 as well. So I want to make it this. Execute. Row updated. I got new salary. See, I'm working with the first table. I haven't touched the second table yet. I have done nothing with the second table. I just created the second table. Now let's check the records of second table. What was the name? Execute. And as you can see, ID 2, new salary, and the message has been inserted automatically on its own. I don't have to do it. So this is your trigger. They are fired automatically. Once you will write the code, once you will decide that when the things will happen and what the things will happen, your trigger will be fired. Clear? So this is your trigger. That's it.